I'm finally doing a thoughts on video for Forever Song.
Hallelujah.
And welcome to Books 101. Today I have my thoughts on a video for Forever Song by Julie Kagawa. Conclusion to the Immortal Rules trilogy. Now, if you haven't picked up the Immortal Rules, I have done a review on the first and the second book, and I'll leave the links down below to that. If you read this trilogy, it's a trilogy about vampires, but this vampire's done well. Like, it's not a crappy vampire book, it's a good vampire book. If that sounds interesting to you, I'll leave the link for the first book, The Immortal Rules, down below. Make sure you go watch that and then see it from there. Today, I'm totally gonna be discussing my thoughts on the conclusion, so if you don't wanna be spoiled, click out. Let's talk. I was so excited when this book came out. I've been waiting a freaking year for this book because, see, when Immortal Rules came out, I got it in a magazine as a sample book and I kind of read it and I thought, And then I'm like, Eternity Cure had just come out then, so I bought Eternity Cure and then I had to wait a year for this one. I really did enjoy the conclusion to this series. My first thoughts on it was a great book. I still think my favorite is The Immortal Rules. I feel the way that this trilogy concluded, I think they had a strong ending. I kind of predicted it, but it was just how it got there that was really interesting. Eternity Cure ended that Zeke was supposedly killed. And this just made Allie just completely like shut off her humanity because she thought, hey,
my boyfriend's dead. I can't leave.
She shut off her humanity. So it was really interesting to see at the beginning of this book, we get a colder Allie. You know, she's more like Jackal, which, well, it kind of started to piss me off a bit. They're on the hunt to kill Zarin. And it's 2 weeks since the events in Eternity Cure. It took a while to get into it because all they're doing is just traveling, traveling, traveling. And the amount of time Jackal's like, kind of got annoying, like it got really annoying. And you know, the amount of times Ellie's like,
I'm turning into a monster, you know, I'm a monster.
So they kill a couple of humans, you know, yada, yada, yada. And as they're walking, they stumble upon this house and it's like, up close the building was a fortress. The walls were brick, reinforced in places with steel bars and plates. A wide trench surrounded the whole house with sharpened iron poles to account for vampires. And I'm just kind of thinking, well, if you're living like in that world, you know, you keep the rapids out, but wouldn't you build a house or like a fence or something to keep the vampires out as well? Like, my heart was actually beating really fast in this scene because when Ellie's in the house, you know how there's like a mum lying in bed like sleeping, and you know she's going over to the mum, blood out of the mum, and then the little girl's like, mommy, and I'm like, oh hell, I hope Ellie doesn't eat the little girl. Like, I hope she doesn't hurt her. And then Allie, of course, doesn't. And I'm like, oh my gosh. And this is where she kind of starts getting her humanity back, which I'm really, really happy for. Brother and sister relationship between Jackal and Allie. You know, I love it and I hate it at the same time. But I really started to find a new respect for Jackal in this book. In Immortal Rules, he's a total dick. But then in Eternity Cure, he gets better. And by this book, you're kind of used to him. You're used to his attitude. But you kind of still don't know which team he's truly on. I love hearing about him and his character. Then head to old Chicago. And a lot of things happened and Zeke comes back into the picture. I knew Zeke deep down would not be dead. Zeke cannot die. Freaking hell, when he was human, he survived like a million and one things. He could never die. When they see each other, like,
hey vampire, again, I knew you'd come for me.
She actually thinks, you know, this was wrong. It could be a trap. She still goes and helps him anyway. And deep down, I'm like, Allie, that's not really Zeke. Something happens to Zeke, Zeke's evil now. And it turns out that he is. When he freaking puts that blade in her chest, I'm just there like, Allie, why the hell you do that? Because as I was reading, I was like, Allie, no, 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 this isn't Zeke. Allie then is just determined to go after Zeke. She's going after Zeke. And I just thought, you go, girl. But then it's so funny because then they go to the pit. They're going for the kill. And I love how Allie's like, you know, I'm gonna kill Zeke. I'm gonna kill Zeke. I'm gonna kill Zeke. And she doesn't end up killing Zeke. He's always like,
you should have killed me.
She's like,
Zeke, I know you can hear me. I know this isn't what you want. Please stop.
The biggest thing was when she's like,
I swallowed, knowing what he wanted. Tilted my head back, bearing my throat to him.
Apparently, as he was drinking her blood, you know, he could see her, see them. I thought that was just so weird. It's just like vampires sucking blood from one another. Anyway, afterwards, Zeke, you know, is in doubt. He's like, oh, I killed people. You know, he's back to his old self and everything, no longer under Saren's control. And I'm just like, Zeke, I know you've done bad things, but you kind of got to get over yourself. Moment when Zeke was going to kill himself in the sun, I was just like, hell, Zeke, stop being so depressed that you're a freaking vampire. You have Ellie there. She's willing to help you. She's awesome. And then he's just like, oh, sun. Then make it to Eden and, you know, things have kind of changed. And then, of course, I kind of suspected that Zeke and Ellie have, you know what? Let's talk about the final battle. I think this is where it all comes down to. Chapter 16 onwards. It's just like, who will win, who will win? We've got Rapids, we've got everything imaginable coming after them as they're trying to kill Zarin. Freaking hell, when Zarin kind of, when he thought he died, and then he came back, and then he wasn't dead, but then got killed, I was just like, freaking hell, that guy just freaking killed the enemy. The saddest part was when Tannin sacrificed himself because he's like, I have the cure in me. Ellie realized that she's the master vampire, the cure's in her. That was just brilliant. I really enjoyed that. And now, like, they can cure everyone. And I thought that was a good ending. Then, the fact that Jackal had to die. I originally thought that Jackal was gonna die. You know, Jackal had the virus, and then I thought, oh shit, you know, he's gonna die, he's gonna die. But then, because then they kind of grow attached to him, but then he didn't die, so I was like, yes. I really liked how, you know, it was just the two of them, Zeke and Ellie. And how, you know, they're gonna, that how they said, oh, you know, we're gonna stop this, we're gonna, you know, make this better. Ends with like,
I love you, vampire girl, and forever is exactly what we have.
I was kind of happy with the ending, but then I was kind of a bit upset as well because I'm like, I could actually have another book, another conflict would happen. But I was very happy with the conclusion to this. Tell me your thoughts about Forever Song. I'd really like to know. That's the end for my mini thoughts on video for Forever Song. I don't have much time today, but I just wanted to, you know, talk about it because I need to talk about this book. I'm Miranda. Thank you so much for watching. See ya.